again for delivering those potions to Madame Lawing. Saved me a lot of time and trouble. A wise decision. Thank you. I hope to see you again. Farewell for now.
There you are. The Crosswands duelist to beat.
What are you doing out here?
Challenging you to a game of Summoner's Court. I think it's time you faced a real opponent, outside of Ronan's little lesson in charms class. Summoner's Court isn't just a game. It's a battle of skill. A test of a witch or wizard's mettle. What say?
I'm in. Let's do it.
Brilliant! Summoner's Court, the ever-changing game. Akio. Nothing to it.
Revelio.
Akio.
That was one for the ages. Akio. All in the wrist. I'll let you have that one. Akio. Try to beat that.
Akio.
Not bad. Not bad. Well done. You beat me. Bit of good luck, that's all.
Come now, Leander. There's no need for that.
Fine, you're good. Better than I am, at least. I'll let the others know you're good enough to keep playing.
The others?
I lost 7 matches in a row to Samantha Dale. The others who play Summoner's Court thought that if you couldn't beat me, you wouldn't be enough of a challenge.
Chin up, Leander. Keep practicing and you'll get better.
I suppose you're right. I'll let the others know that your mettle's been tested and that you passed.
I haven't been called Puffskeen Dunkeen once since you brought me that venomous tentacular leaf. I think I am actually braver.
Revelio. Revelio.
You can't imagine how inconvenient.
Revelio. Hello again, Mr. Moon.
Oh, I was hoping to see you again, my young friend. Gladwin Moon, Hogwarts caretaker, at your service. First, please allow me to apologize if I seemed a bit unsteady when we last met. I'm afraid I had a rather disconcerting encounter. Although I hear your visit to Hogsmeade was even more eventful than mine.
I suppose you could call it eventful. I certainly wasn't expecting a troll attack.
Oh, of course not! From what I understand, the village was lucky you were there. In fact, my recent visit to Hogsmeade is the reason I was hoping to bump into you. I could use your help with something. Do you see that curious statue over there? Watch what happens when that light changes from day to night. Now, if you wouldn't mind humoring me for a moment, see if you can remove the moon from the statue. Ooh, odd little contraptions, aren't they? It seems the statue vanishes once the moon is removed. Which, incidentally, can only be done at night. Why don't you hold on to that one for now, and I'll explain more as we walk. Ever since that fateful day in the village, those curious statues have begun appearing about the castle. A fair number have been strewn around Hogsmeade. Someone, it seems, is trying to torment me. You see, that day in Hogsmeade, I turned a corner and came face to face with a boggart, or shapeshifter, if you will, which takes the form of whatever scares you most. This one took the form of a demiguise.
A demiguise?
Yes! Terrifying creature that can see the future. Wholly unnerving. I encountered one when I was a lad in Korea. Terrible experience. Those statues are demiguises. The moons, I assume, are an uninspired play on my name. Some jackanapes used a boggart to learn my greatest fear and use it against me. I have my suspicion as to the scoundrel or scoundrels responsible. It is my hope that they will slip up and reveal themselves as the statues disappear. That is why I need your help in removing the statues.
Why me?
A couple of reasons, frankly. First, your daring do against those trolls in Hogsmeade has gained you a reputation for fearlessness. Second, as macabre and hideous as a demiguise is, most would find my fear of them unwarranted. You, however, have seen how they affect me. I'm at my wit's end, young friend. I simply can't bring myself to go near them. In fact, I know of two statues right here in the faculty tower. Perhaps you could start simply by removing them, so I can go about my evening duties.
I'd be glad to help you, Mr. Moon.
Oh, I knew I could count on you. First, you know how to cast a disillusionment charm, correct? You'll want to do that before wandering the tower at night. Next, you'll notice that the door is locked. However will you get in? Alohomora, that's how.
But what about curfew?
Curfew? Oh, tosh. I sense you're a bit like me when I was your age. Oh, the school was my oyster. And I took advantage of it. Oh, everyone loved me for it. Oh, those were the days. Now, you'll find one statue in the prefect's bathroom and the other in the hospital wing. Good luck. Oh, and thank you.
Alohomora.
Done! You're in! Remember, use a disillusionment charm so no one claps eyes on you. This is a restricted area of the castle, after all.
Revelio. Ahamora.
Caught you sneaking about, didn't I?
Revelio. Aloha, Mora. Aloha, Mora.
How are your students?
Revelio.
Boy, I say.
Is that so?
We're raising a generation of coddled cape flappers that can scarcely tell the difference between Aconite and Asphodel.
Yes, well, it's still early.
This must be the prefect's bathroom.
are preparing for a rebellion. Brutes, always mucking about, stirring up trouble. Perhaps Ranrock and Hizzot would have been called if the Ministry would allow them to have wands. One of those goblins comes near me, I'll hand him his hand. Or hell, but anyway, I'm not afraid of rebellion. My marks in Professor Heckert's class are superb. I don't think that's what that class is for. She's right. Why don't you leave goblins alone? House points. No, you can't do that.
Revelio.
Of my venomous tentacular?
Not at the moment, no. Plenty of other perils and pitfalls to send them my way, though.
Revelio.
It's a majestic sport. Encompasses the whole of the human condition.
How's that?
Well, all of the teamwork and the golden.
Hello, Mr. Moon. I have the moons you asked me to collect.
Oh, goodness! You're as fearless as I'd hoped. An excellent start. If we can collect more, it may shed some light on who's behind all this. Of course, I first suspected Peeves. He drove the previous caretaker, Rancorous Carp, to an early retirement with his intolerable buffoonery. But that does not explain the boggart in Hogsmeade, does it? No. I am determined, with your help, to discover the identity of my tormentor.
It's definitely intriguing. I'd like to help you solve this mystery.
You, my friend, are a gentle person and a scholar. And I have something to offer in exchange for your assistance. Now, remember, the moons are only retrievable at night. Thus, I encourage you to use a disillusionment when necessary.
Understood. I shall keep an eye out.
I appreciate that. Oh, and I knew you were the one to ask for help. Keep at it so we can solve this mystery. Love you so.
Oh, you are too kind.
Revelio. 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 Revelio.
Finite. Revelio. Finite.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included. Welcome, everyone. I see you've already met some of the many beasts we study in this class. Though be advised, none of these creatures should be taken lightly. They are all in their own way dangerous, especially if one does not know how to handle them properly. Now, it seems many of you are out of practice. Let's take some time to review the basics of how to care for a beast, shall we? Miss Sweeting, would you please assist our new student with the lesson today?
Yes, Professor Howen. Hello, I'm Poppy. Poppy Sweeting. Don't worry about Professor Howen's speech. She over-exaggerates sometimes. All the beasts in class are perfectly safe. Oh!
Miss Sweeting, pay attention, please. The tongue of a Puffskin can be a slippery devil.
Yes, Professor. Here. You can practice on Gerald. Just keep an eye out for his tongue. You can use my brush. Just be gentle. Oh, and think pleasant thoughts. I like to think it enriches his experience. That's lovely. I'm sure he feels much better. I think he might be hungry. Would you mind giving him some beast feed? What do you suppose the pellets taste like to Gerald? Pudding, I like to think. I think we can safely say that Gerald likes you.
That's good news. He seems very nice.
He is. Kindness is one of his best qualities, right after ambition. And cleanliness.
Good work, everyone. Now, let's make our way to the pens and select another beast. And please, do be careful as you feed and groom them. Miss Sweeting, why don't you show our new student to the Neasels in the farthest pen?
This way. The Neasels are over here.
Oh, couple of Neasel whiskers ought to get me a few canuts at least. Enough to buy something from Honeydukes. Stupid thing.
What in Merlin's name are you doing?
Tuss, peculiar Poppy. Worried about a worthless little rodent.
Her name is Persephone!
Her name is Persephone!
That's really not funny.
Let's go.
Those two don't belong anywhere near this class. Poachers in training. Persephone was onto them instantly. Thank you for your help. Let's carry on. Feed and brush the measles, just as you did with Gerald. The measles really took to you. They know a good egg when they see one. As do I.
It appears our time has come to an end. Please close the pens and see yourselves out. Now, where is our new student? Ah, there you are. I would like a moment, please.
Hello, Professor. You wanted to speak with me?
I did. How did you find your first beast's lesson?
It was...
Psst. Psst. Over here.
Do you need something, Poppy?
Thank you again for saying... It's something my gran and I say. We're of a similar mind.
You've intrigued.
I wouldn't take just anyone there. In fact, you're the first.
Really? Well, thank you, I think.
As I said, we think alike. Pleasant surprise. Quite the weather we're having, don't you think?
Poppy, where are you taking me?
It really is much better if I just show you. Don't worry, we're nearly there. It's just ahead. Stand back. Magnificent. Go on, introduce yourself to her. But be careful. You must always show hippogriffs the proper courtesy before you approach them. Someone this quickly. You can feed and brush her if you'd like. I come and check on her every once in a while. Bring her pasties, tell her what's going on in the castle. You wouldn't know from looking at her, but she's a dreadful busybody. What did you think of Highwing?
I thought she was brilliant. Can't believe you introduced me to her.
I suspected you two might get along.
Are you the reason students have been seeing hippogriffs flying above the Forbidden Forest?
Perhaps. Did you know that once you earn a hippogriff's trust, they'll always be there for you? I've seen it firsthand with her.
How exactly did you and Highwing cross paths?
It's a longer story, but I rescued her from poachers a few years back. Got her to safety and, well, she was fine until recently. You may have noticed that poachers are something of a problem in the area, so I worry they could get her again. They're up to something.
That does... I think that's a...
I should be...
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
The ministry thinking.
I really have made a mess of things.
I sent a love letter to an older one.
Revelio. Revelio.
Wish I could afford my own brew from Spint Witches.
Nothing beats a leisurely evening flight.
Lumos.
I think I'll go for a quick sprint on my broom after class tonight. I find it helps stimulate my mind, especially if we've had a class.
Revelio.
Do we have?
Hello, Homura.
Revelio. Alohomora. Revelio.
Deke thinks you should be proud of all the potions you've brewed.
Thank you.
wonder what Merlin would think of it.
Come on inside. Oh, watch yourself.
Revelio.
If you're alive.
Hello.
Oh, hello. Whew, I suppose it's my own fault. By the way, welcome to Dogweed and Deathcap. Oh, if there wasn't the constant... Except, of course, for... Mind you don't...
What do you have for sale?
Well, what say we show you some of what's available? A wee bairn gaeing a thrashing to a troll. Oh, I can't believe it. Doors always open. Stop by soon. Doors always open. Stop by soon. Well, what say we show you some of what's available? Your things will be safe with me until they're sold. Then you'll have to make do with money. Oh, I'm always thrilled when a young one makes a wise purchase. I can tell you'll go far. Doors always open. You be sure to stop by soon.